Tonight, from Bank of America Stadium in Charlotte, North Carolina, it's the NFC Divisional Round Playoffs on EA Sports. It's the Carolina Panthers taking on the Detroit Lions.
The Carolina rains have arrived as we are inside a soggy Bank of America Stadium in Charlotte. Just ahead, we'll decide the second entrant to next week's NFC title game. And we got a great one in store as it'll be the Detroit Lions taking on the Carolina Panthers. Hello, everyone. As the postseason continues here on EA Sports, we're pleased to bring it to you. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden. And who has the edge here? You got one side that had some extra rest, but another comes in off a win last week in the wild card round.
And it's funny, depending on which team you are, you say that that's an advantage. You'll take the rest. You'll take the week off. Get your guys healed up a little bit and ready to go. But that team that's coming in off of a win last week, they're really excited to keep playing. They feel like they are hot and ready to go.
And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape, up past the 30. So here are the Lions now coming out for their opening drive. They're led onto the field by the former Cal Bear and the number one overall pick in 2016, Jared Goff.
All in all, he was pretty solid in the victory in the wild card round and threw a couple of touchdowns. And when it comes to quarterback play, you'd always love spectacular, but in the playoffs, you'll take solid, and that's exactly what they're looking for from him again in this contest.
Shotgun snap for Goff. Yeah, they will touch him down, but not before he gets the first. 12 yards on third down as the drive rolls on.
Well, a lot of times when you get a manageable third down situation like this, you have to think about your tight end, and he comes through for him, picking up the first down.
On first down, Goff. That's complete to Peoples Jones. And just 1 yard here from the 49 to the 50. Second and nine. Head off to Gibbs, headed right here. Trying to find a lane, but instead he'll get back to the line of scrimmage. And no more. Here's third and nine. From the 50, it's Goff. He's got his target. That's complete. And they're going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Panthers' 29-yard line. A good pickup there, a 22.
Well, that was a fun one to watch right there. A nice in-breaking route and plenty of room in the middle of the field. And he was able to get behind the linebackers and grab the completion for a really good pickup.
Now a first down throw, gone. Finding Williams once more, complete. Call it a gain of 6 on the play, and that's going to bring up second down. Now back to the ground, here's Gibbs. And they'll bring him down at the 18-yard line. So from inside the 20, here's first and 10 at the 18. A Another run for Gibbs here. And he'll take it from the 18 to the 15. A gain of 3. Second and 7. Now gone. Throw left side complete to Troutman. His first reception of the divisional round matchup, but it's good for a first down as well.
First drive of the game. We did see this in practice, didn't we? Because they allowed us to stay and watch and see what their opening script would be, even though we don't know the exact play calls. That looks a lot like what we saw them execute, doesn't it?
Now the pressure gets there, and he goes down just inside the 20 at the 19. Shaq Thompson making his presence felt on the sack.
Well, there's still time to rectify this situation because the silver lining, they took a sack on first and goal. But that close to the goal line, that still definitely hurts.
First down, a bit of a disaster, and now on second and goal, back even further. Goff. Well, this is caught by Williams. And they'll work this down to the 15 for a pickup of 4. Interested to see what they dial up here. Third and goal with a lot of green between them and the end zone. Out of the gun. Goff. Toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete. Now Greg Joseph for the field goal try. From the left hash, just a 32-yard attempt. Joseph's got it. And the Lions are going to take a 3-0 lead. Not a touchdown, obviously, but playoffs, you're on the road. At least you put something on the board.
I would agree with that totally. You're not exactly sending a message to the opposition, but you are letting them know that you came to play.
And Thomas just going to hold on to this one. It's a touchback. So here now are the Panthers for their first drive of the game. And they are led out there by their mobile quarterback.
For a guy still in his second year in the NFL, this is obviously a big spot for him to try and fill. Able to engineer the victory in the wild card round last weekend, that's got to give him confidence, and it's got to elevate the confidence of his teammates as well. But as he said after the win, things are only going to get tougher from there. He understands the situation he's in. He understands what's ahead of him in this one.
He'll be dropped after a gain of about 6 across the 30 to the 31. They'll come up now 2nd and 4 from the 31. Looking to throw. Green. Man open. That's Jamar Chase complete. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. It's a Carolina first down on a gain of 16.
You can see the time and effort and thought that they put into their passing game because it was evident right there. It looks like a simple pitch and catch, but you and I both know that they have planned for this and worked hard to make it happen.
First carry here for Ken Walker. Looking for a seam, but finding none. He'll get back to the line of scrimmage, and that's it. No gain on the play. It'll be 2nd down.
As usual, the hallmark of a good run defense, linebackers making plays near the line of scrimmage. Absolutely nowhere to run there.
Now he'll look to throw here on 2nd and 10. So 5 yards here, 5 on the play. And now 3rd down and 6 to go. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. Got a man. It's Chase. He completes it. And he is going to have the Panthers 1st down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion.
And if they're throwing on 3rd down, it's a good bet. They're going to look his way. He's the most reliable of their receivers. And he comes through there with a nice grab for the 1st down.
Now to the ground. Here's Walker. On a nice burst there as he'll take this inside the 30 to the 28-yard line. 13 yards, first down, Panthers.
A good run there off right tackle in an old school NFL football. The right side of the offensive line, often known as the nasty side. The left side, usually the technical side. Kind of reminds me of the old Atlanta Falcons 2009-2010. That's how they constructed their offensive line.
On first down, he'll drop to throw. He'll find Thielen work in the middle. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. Another nice gain. That's now 30 yards between those last two plays. 3-0 after one on EA Sports. Second quarter now from Charlotte, and it's the Panthers with the football as they've got it with a first and 10. Out of the gun, Walker with it. And here he'll get it down to the 7. Second and 6 with the ball on the 7. Sticking with Walker on second down. And he's able to get it down to the 2-yard line. They'll try for the first with Walker. 2 yards is the pickup. And the Panthers are set up now with a first and goal.
I hope we give enough respect to the big guys up front because they have been getting it done on this drive. The holes have been large, and they've been barreling through them, picking up first downs.
Walker, and no signal yet. I don't think he got in. He didn't. They'll mark him at the 1. Another shot from the 1 on second and goal. They're going to run this with a tight end. And he takes it into the end zone for a Panthers touchdown. Tommy Trimble taking it in from a yard out. And the Panthers have taken the lead.
All drives that result in points hurt a defense, but when they are the sustained variety, play after play, and they just can't get off the field and stop them, that can be demoralizing.
Aldrich Rosas on for the extra point. And this is up and good to make it 7-3. That one in the books as a 12-play drive. And it ends with a 1-yard touchdown run. The Carolina kick team is out there ready to go, and they kick this one away. Donovan Peoples-Jones now from the end zone. And no alley to be found. The coverage was solid, and he's dropped at the 18. So out now come the Lions. One semi-factor, if you want to call it that, that was brought up in the papers this morning here, Charles. You got a dome team on the road in a cold weather environment, first round of the playoffs in January. Do you think that's a big deal?
Ordinarily, I say no, but in this...
Oh, he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted. And he will bring this one back. It's a pick six for a Panther touchdown. Well, CD, we have seen it many times throughout the course of the season. This defense coming up large and snagging a big takeaway. But here they get not just the takeaway, 6 points as well.
And you just knew that for this team to advance, it had to get a big performance from this unit. And to this point, they've delivered.
Rosas now to add the PAT. This one's right through to make it a 14-3 ball game. So the defense creating some points, not only getting the interception, but then returning it to the end zone for the pick six. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six, and now the kick is away. Peoples-Jones going to elect not to run this out, and they'll begin at the 25. And Detroit back in possession of the football. And this not an easy situation. You're down early in the elements. You're on the road, How do you get the mojo back?
Well, one thing is to remember that as an offensive player, you have a much better idea of what you're trying to accomplish and where you're trying to go than the defender. So in this case, because you know it, you can make your cuts with a little more decisiveness, maybe a second fake, some double moves, things of that nature, to go ahead and try and put some pressure on the defense.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Goff now to throw. Oh, he was hit as he threw it there, and that one winds up incomplete. So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. Now a play fake, and it's gone. And this throw incomplete. Now the defender all over him that time, and it's going to lead to third down.
It's another zone defense. It looks like it's open for possibilities, but they did a nice job patrolling the middle of the field and forcing an incompletion.
The Lions on third down. They've been okay, 2 for 3 thus far. This is third and 10. Throwing again is Goff. The Panther rush too strong. They get there and take him down. T.J. Watt able to get him down for a loss of 11. And it brings up fourth down.
Now that was just absolute perfect man coverage. Nowhere for them to go with the football, led to a sack. And that's really difficult to do in today's NFL with all these gazelles running around that you're trying to cover in the secondary.
Jack Fox out to punt here on fourth down. Oh, he shifts past him. It'll be a 39-yard punt, give him a good 10 yards on the return. And they will take over first and 10. The Panthers coming back out onto the field for their second drive. And they'll just simply be looking to build off the confidence of the last time out where they scored a touchdown.
And confidence is powerful, isn't it? When you've scored once, you feel like you can go back out there and get it done again. Doesn't matter what the defense throws at them, they feel like they're in a groove right now, and they want to get out there and show it.
Yeah, hoping to stay in that groove here this go-around. And he'll be corralled out across midfield down to the 45. 16 yards right off the bat and a first down. Throw. Green. Quick slant caught by Chase. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. Walker now on first and 10. And not much running room. Down to the 32. From the 32-yard line now, here's a second down and 9. Looking to throw. Green. Third catch for him on his drive alone, and it'll give him a first down. Now they'll throw here, out of the gun. For Marshall, that's complete. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, second and 2. Back to throw. Green, over the middle, he's got Chenault. And the Panthers are going to be set up with a first and goal coming up as they get him down at the 6-yard line. Here's Walker. And he gets halfway there from the 6 to the 3 on a gain of 3. Two of their 3 red zone trips so far, they've come up empty on. They'll look to reverse that trend on second. And it's intercepted at the goal line. Picked off by Cameron Sutton. And the Lions are going to take over here on the INT at their own 5-yard line. A reminder, as we did all through the regular season, we'll check in with Jonathan Coachman at halftime. He'll have highlights and analysis of this first half of play. And a short gain here as he gets it up only to about the 6. They work now on 2nd and 9. He'll get that one to Carter complete. Now the Panthers going to use the first of their timeouts. as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. Here's third and seven. Now it's gone. Oh, and his early struggles continue. Here's another one intercepted. Picked by Antoine Winfield Jr. And they'll spot him at the 3-yard line. With such a costly interception, nearly a pick six, but now they're so close, they are knocking on the door for a touchdown.
And I never want to get on any team for being aggressive, because that's part of what their makeup is, and oftentimes it's successful. But in this case, you've got to be selective about it and make sure you take care of the football. That interception almost cost them 6 points. Now their defense has to run onto the field, probably give them the quarterback a few side eyes along the way. They've got to see if they can stop a score.
Now the first play of the drive there is incomplete. They'll go again from the 3 here on second and goal. Operating from the gun, Green. And he's got it. Touchdown, Panthers. Kenneth Walker from 3 yards out. And the Panthers continue to show why it pays to play at home in the postseason as they add on to their lead. Well, Charles, after the first quarter, it was just complete disaster for them. Everything has flipped. I mean, it's 180 degrees in the other direction now here in quarter two.
Championship effort right there. How about them marching almost the length of the field, coming through on their final opportunity to get the win? This is one that this team will remember forever, as well as their fans.
Footing always a concern, but the extra points up and good. And the lead is up to 18 now. Carolina kick team is out there ready to go, and they kick this one away. Peoples-Jones going to elect not to run this out, and they'll begin at the 25. The Lions offense set to take over. And Charles, we'll see what they can do here. Not a ton of time left, but enough certainly to get points out of this drive, and they need them right now because they're trailing.
Yeah, this is exactly why you practice a 2-minute drill all through camp and at least one practice each week before a game. A minute left, more than enough time to string a few completions together, reach the end zone, and then make that walk back to the locker room just a little more animated.
They're going to need to get up and set in a hurry. And he's going to be taken down. Goff is sacked. The Lions will use the first of their timeouts as he'll stop it with exactly a minute to go before halftime. And he'll be stopped at the 27-yard line, well short of the first down marker. The Panthers going to use the second of their timeouts as the stoppage will come with a little under a minute to go in this first half. And here now the punter, Fox, as he sends this one away. They'll score that a 36-yard punt. And it will be first and 10 as they take over. The Panthers going to go back on offense here late in this first half. And with great starting field position and one timeout in their pocket, they could still come away with points here in the late going. Good starting position for the Panthers as they come up first and 10 at their 38. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. Opted to run for it. The decision a good one. Picking up the first, getting 14 yards on the scramble. Green on first down. So the completion good for 6 yards, and that'll bring up second down. The final shot before break. Green, he will find his man Chase, complete, and it's going to be another first down as they'll get him to the ground at the Lions 21. So we've come upon halftime here in this NFC divisional round matchup as we'll get you down the coast to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman and our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach!
All right, Brandon, thanks very much. We'll get back to you and Charles in a minute. But first, time to give the folks at home a look at what's going on around the NFL. We'll start over in Texas at AT&T Stadium in Arlington, where it was definitely a game with some intrigue, as you can see by the scoreline. Dak Prescott, excellent in the W, as his guys get victory number 12 on the year.
All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number 3. A trip to the NFC title game hanging in the balance. Second half action back underway. And the tackle going to be made right there at the 25-yard line. Out come the Panthers. They'll have it first on offense in the third quarter. As this offense takes the field to begin the opening drive of the second half, Charles, remember in that first half, good through the air and really all around an outstanding offensive performance.
Absolutely. They've reached the end zone several times. The passing game working awfully well, and most importantly, partner.
Yeah, they went into the tunnel with a lead. They come back out with that lead.
Absolutely. NFL coaches, we know they're perfectionists in a lot of ways, but they had to like what they saw in that first half.
They've got the lead early here in the third quarter, and runs like that are how they establish that lead in the first half.
I love the fact that you're using the word lead, because they are leading from the front, pounding on the defense right now with the running game, and truly establishing themselves here in the second half.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Again, it's Walker. And he fights forward for a modest 2-yard gain. Second down. Looking to throw. Green. And he'll slide to a halt here. Still a little shy of the first down marker. For the Lions, an extra DB in the game now here on third down. From the gun, it's Walker, and he will have the first down as he's brought down up near midfield.
Third and two, right? So this is a situation where low man has got to win at the line of scrimmage, but it's not just the low man winning. It's the low man who's winning with some force, and they had that to pick up the first down.
Barely picking it up, but they did. Two first downs have him up near midfield now on first and 10. They'll give this to Moss running right. Gets past one man. Oh, they nearly sprung him that time as he takes this all the way down to the 37. 14 yards, good for a Panther first down.
Not too shabby for his first carry of the game. That's exactly what most teams are looking for, a really good change of pace back.
On this drive so far. It's first and 10. Now they'll switch it up here and look to throw. Yeah, that's good for a gain of 6. And it'll be second down.
Nothing fancy on first down, but a very consistent type of a play. Hit that slant. A lot of people call it an extension of the running game, and it can be if that pass is completed, because you hit a guy on the run like that, he often can go for big yardage.
Sets him up nicely for second down, staying ahead of schedule. On second down, it's Walker. He can't get him down. Taking it right down Broadway. And they move this all the way down to the 9. 23 yards on the pickup there and a first. He had his eyes on the end zone once he hit the secondary, but they're finally able to slow him down.
Yeah, and I've got to look at this one from the defensive point of view. You just mentioned finally able to slow him down. They've got to figure out a way to make that at the point of attack, at the line of scrimmage, because once he gets through, he's shredding them.
They'll run with Gibson. And he's going to ball his way down to about the one-yard line. Good yardage on first down. Now can they punch it in on second and goal? Back to throw. Green. He's got it for a Panther touchdown. Jamar Chase from a yard out. And the Panthers take the opening kickoff of the third quarter and drive right down the field to extend their lead. There was no going through the progressions on that touchdown pass.
Yeah, nor was it necessary. His receiver won that route early, presented himself. No reason to wait. Go ahead and put it on him and score a touchdown.
PAT up and good by Rosas. And they open the lead up now to 25. The kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. Peoples-Jones going to elect not to run this out, and they'll begin at the 25. So we get a look at the Lions offense as they get ready for their first possession of the second half.
The CD, they certainly know the hole that they face as they begin the second half. They have to do what precious few teams have done in NFL history. Let's try to come back from a four-possession deficit.
And, partner, you know, as that team gathers, they're saying to each other, you never say never, right? Because if you're on an NFL roster, that's how you have to think. You can always come back and win a ball game. And let's face it, we saw a certain Super Bowl, a 25-point lead late that wasn't enough to put someone away. But that being said, this task is near impossible. Let's face it. And bottom line is, it officially becomes impossible if this possession is an empty one. There's a nice pickup right there. And after watching that play, I'm thinking about all the lost opportunities that they've had so far in this game. But right now, just focus on continuing to move the ball the way they did on the last play.
Inside 4 minutes to go, third quarter. Goff on first down. And he's going to be intercepted for the third time thus far. It's Shaq Thompson here with a pick. And a huge return as he'll take this one all the way down inside the 30-yard line. This defense, Charles, coming up with another interception. They have really done an excellent job of locking up these receivers.
Yeah, they're really on fire. They are actually doing what they talk about all the time, which is plastering to receivers when they're in their zones. They didn't give up a touchdown in the first half. Haven't done so here in this half either. Blanketed the field going all the way back to the opening drive, and they come up with a pick right there.
Drain down. Throwing to start the drive. Oh, now he's stripped. He lost the football. And this is scooped up by the Lions. There he goes, right side. And he'll take this all the way down inside the 40.
I don't care what the scoreboard says, partner. You know who's winning this game right now?
Mother Nature?
Yes, indeed. Precipitation's winning in a big way. Sloppy, sloppy. All these turnovers right now.
Yeah, well, this was the forecast. We got what was forecasted, and we've gotten a lot of turnovers. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. 56, the mic, boys. 56. Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. Oh, he dropped it. And that's pretty indicative of the way this one's gone.
That was nice work there defensively to force the incompletion. Now, even though this drive started in plus territory, they're still not in field goal range yet. So they can work towards another couple of stops and not allowing that turnover to hurt.
From the gun, here's Goff. Now he drops it incomplete, and their struggles continue here. So back-to-back incompletions, and that has them staring at a third and 10. The throw is gone. Finds Gibbs on the check down. And a good job defensively. They stop him short of the first at the 32. They do get 7 out of that, but not enough to prevent a fourth down.
How about that strategy there, Brandon? Third down, they just said, we've got faith in our tacklers. We'll give you the short stuff, and just decided to protect the sticks. So every time I hear fans telling me tackling's not a part of the game anymore, plays like that, I can clip and save and show them you have to tackle well if you want to be a good defense.
Fourth down, a give to Gibbs. And he's got the first as they'll bring him down at the 28-yard line. They'll go again with Gibbs. And boy, this defense again really making things tough on him as they stop him for no gain. Second and 10 now, third quarter from Charlotte. Now a first carry for their fullback. And he's brought down at the 24 after a gain of four. Seventh play of the drive upcoming here on third and six. Goff now looks to throw. Open man right side is St. Brown. And out of bounds right around the 20. Needing the tough yards, they run it with their fullback. And he is going to have the Lions first down as he gets a little more than he needed. 4 yards to pick up there on fourth and two. Now Goff. And that'll be knocked away. It's incomplete. Now a second and 10. And they'll run here with Carter. And they'll get to him just inside the 15, even after that strong run we witnessed. One quarter remains for a trip to the NFC title game. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports. And we're back now in Charlotte. This offense so far on third down, they've struggled to the tune of 2 for 8 so far. This is third and 8. And it's caught and stopped a few yards shy of the goal line at the 3. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
And with this game well in hand, perhaps we are seeing the coverage lighten up a little bit as they got burned there a bit for a first down.
Well, we certainly know the coach isn't happy along the sideline because he certainly wants him to finish this one out the way they started it. He doesn't want to give up any soft completions, no late points. He wants his lead to stay right where it is.
Off play action. Here's Goff. And he is going to go down. Back at the 11-yard line. T.J. Watt bringing the pressure yet again. That's his third sack here tonight.
Well, this has to count as a great team effort today, but this man, he's been at the center of all of it. Really special day for any defense to have this many sacks in a game. Even more so for this player. One of the best individual efforts of the season.
So they get pushed back to the 11, and here's second and goal. There's Goff. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete. This defense has not surrendered a touchdown yet. You better believe they're determined not to here on third and goal. Goff now looking to throw. Ball had his hands on it, couldn't bring it in. Pretty symptomatic of how this game's been going. Desperation time for Goff on fourth. And it's intercepted at the goal line. Picked off by J.C. Horn. And he will bring this one back. It's a pick six. Panther touchdown.
Well, what has been a fantastic game for this defense has been rough for this offense, and certainly a signal caller, Charles, that's thrown all these interceptions. Another one there, and this one taken all the way back for the score.
Partner hoping to hold a nice little spot in the postgame highlights to show this rip of interceptions and great plays this group has made. They've been on it from snap one.
Rosas to add the extra point. And he's been a busy man, 5 for 5 now as he knocks another one through to extend the lead. A heck of a play there defensively, getting the interception, navigating his way into the end zone for the touchdown. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. And he brings us out past the 20 to the 24. They were trying to create some space to run. They created the penalty.
And you work on it so much. You work on it so hard. But it's tough to simulate game speed in practice that often runs you into a penalty.
They lead big, and a major part of that has been how they've taken their play to a whole new level this second half. No points allowed since the break, and you can add another incompletion to the total number that they forced in this runaway contest.
And he works it across the 25 before being tackled. They'll get 17 that time, and the Lions have a first down.
Well, this game is certainly pretty well over. They go ahead and mark it in the win column. But as a defense, they don't want to get so soft now that everybody just throws the ball all over the place against them, gets big yardage, and puts points on the board. They have pride, too, on that side of the ball.
First and 10, Goff. He'll go right back to St. Brown. And he takes us beyond the 35 before going out of bounds.
It's a nice completion and a little bit of run after catch as well to create the yardage that they got. But it is so tough to cover that route, the drag route, because they run it at varying speeds, because the key is to create hesitancy on the defender's part.
Always so empathetic for those DBs, aren't you? First catch for him in these playoffs. He was held without one last week, but he's got a first down on that effort. Back to throw, Goff.
And boy, another ill-advised throw there as that will wind up incomplete.
On second down, here's Goff. Pressure comes in, he's brought down. It's a Panther sack. T.J. Watt, make that now four sacks for him in tonight's ball game.
My man, it's been a rough night for that offensive line, and it's only getting rougher. Five sacks now that they've given up in this contest so far. It feels like the witching hour out here, doesn't it?
Okay, stupid question. What's the witching hour?
Yeah, the witching hour. That's when everything goes haywire late at night.
So now following the sack, Goff and the Lions needing to come up with something here on third and long. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. He finds his man, complete. It's Carter. And he'll be brought down shy of the 40 at the 38-yard line. It's a gain of 11, but they're still well short. It's fourth down.
I think the good offensive coordinators of the league now are looking at the fullback position and finding the right guys to hide in that spot and increase their passing game, as we just saw there. How about the run after catch? Racked him.
Well, yeah, whether it's a true fullback, a tight end, you put in the fullback spot, you know they're going to be tough to bring down if you can get them the football in the passing game. And he is going to have the Lions first down, and they come up with a big one there to keep the drive moving and then some. Fourth down, trailing in the fourth quarter. They felt compelled to go for it, and they got it.
Well, I'd look down at my play sheet, and what I would find, plays that have been successful throughout the game that have worked at the distance you need, and that's exactly what they got done.
So after the big play on fourth, here's first and 10. Here's Goff. Got his man complete over the middle. That's Carter. It'll go down as a gain of six, and it'll be second down. Again, Goff. Back-to-back catches here for Carter. And he'll work it inside the 30 to the 29-yard line. On first down, it's Goff. Throw left side complete. That's Gibbs.
Ball on the 27. Here's a second and 8.
Goff.
Setting up the screen. This is Gibbs.
And a nice job to break free of one tackle, but it slowed his momentum somewhat, and he's taken down right after. So tug on the face mask, and that's going to cost him 15 yards.
And sometimes it'll go unnoticed, but that one, pretty obvious for everyone to see.
And now it's first and 10, a big mistake, especially when you factor in the personal foul yardage. From the red zone now, Goff. And that incompletion breaks a string of five straight connections. And it's second down. Here's Goff. And he will throw this one out of the back of the end zone. It's incomplete.
Well, we've talked about it, CD, but it bears repeating. They are struggling to throw the football. All the interceptions and more incompletions. It just doesn't look like things are in sync out there.
I would agree with that, and it's not a good day when you feel like an incomplete pass is almost a win for you because it wasn't intercepted. I think the receivers now, when they're running their routes, they want to catch the ball, but they also want to make sure that the defenders don't take it away.
And he's not going to get anywhere close to the marker as they'll stop him well short of the yellow line.
The end result was brute force on brute force. But think about everything that's going on if you're playing defensive tackle. You're dealing with at least one blocker across from you, trying to deal with him, shed him, and maybe even a second one before you have to try and make the tackle on the big guy.
Here's Greg Joseph now to try the field goal. This from 25 yards out. Flip it to the kicker. He looks like he's going to throw it. And oh, the gamble fails. It's incomplete. They pass up the three, fake it. It doesn't work. And this long drive is going to wind up yielding nothing. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive.
Well, we've reached the stage where it's a mere formality at this point. They've got the comfortable lead. We know what the outcome is going to be. I guess the only question is, do they want to put more points on the board before the final gun?
Well, I certainly hope not. And I'm being selfish here because you and I have flights to catch. Let's go ahead and finish this one off, guys. You've taken care of business. Let's close it out. And you and I, let's get to the airport.
And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves them with 2 to go on second down. Walker with another carry. And this is going to be a Panthers first down as the tackle made at the 35-yard line. They'll fake the jet sweep and go instead with Walker. And the tackle there by C.J. Gardner-Johnson.
Well, that last run makes this a 100-yard night. I've loved the way he's hit the holes. He's been quick, he's been decisive, and he's been a whole lot of fun to watch.
And they're moving on to the conference championship. How about this?
What a tremendous feeling to get to the game that can get you to the Super Bowl. A fantastic season. Unfortunately, for the other team, a tough, tough way for it to end.
Just about do it for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, log on to easports.com. The Panthers are winners here as we say so long from Charlotte.